All right, Big James. Anaheim One 2020. Back in the day, did you see yourself at Anaheim One in 2020?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not.
So, you know, it's been a long, 13 months since Malcolm got hurt, 12 months? Yeah. About a year. A lot of rebuilding going on. Where do you think he is right now?
I think he's better at this point than he was a year ago. Yeah. I think he's a year older, he's smarter, he's definitely in better shape.
Yeah. What do you think, what did it take for him to, for that little switch to flip for him to start training more?
My biggest thing, I think, that he always had the talent. Everybody always told him how good he was. And I just think, you know, I told him, you know, back in the Geico days, it's like, whatever day you wake up and say, this is what I want to do, and here's what I got to do it, I said, you'll be on the top.
Yeah.
But you have to do it. No one can tell you. You got to make up your mind to do it. And I just think that he realized that even when we went to the Gibb racing team, that doesn't matter how good the bike is, if I'm not as good as my bike, it doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that was a wake-up call that he realized. It was like, man, I'll just put a little effort into it. And that's all it started from, just putting a little bit in it. And I always tell my kids, what you put in it is what you get out of it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Half-ass it, well, guess what?
Half-ass results. Yeah. How would you compare James and Malcolm as far as talent versus work ethic?
Malcolm has more natural talent than little James, but what liking talent of little James make up for heart.
Yeah.
And little James was always dedicated to racing, even mm-hmm. as a youngster. And it was just, all he knew was racing.
Mm-hmm.
Malcolm knows a lot of other things, and he has fun at a lot of other things, but yeah. Little James didn't.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, to answer your question fairly, I think Malcolm has more natural talent.
Wow, you really?
But less heart. And okay. The heart makes up the difference from Little James. And that's why it's like, well, Malcolm can sit on the couch for months and get off, and like he never missed a beat.
Yeah.
Well, a lot of guys take a little bit to get the nerves and everything back up.
So how do you teach heart? Can you teach heart?
Something you gotta have. It's something that, it's in you, it's just a way of bringing it out of you. And with Malcolm, Bill, he have to, you know, it's just like having a trainer. The trainer can give you every tool that you can, that you need to be the best trainer. But if it's not in your heart, it's not what you want to do, you know, you're just going to, you know, go through the motion with it.
Yeah. You know, I've personally seen a huge gain in his, you know, fitness. So when we started riding bicycles together, I used to be waiting for him, you know? And dude, he is fast now.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I mean, it's just like, it's one of those things that if you get tired of getting your butt kicked, you learn how to fight.
Yeah.
And that's all what happened with Mark, learning how to fight.
What is it like watching your two boys? How does it differ? Like, is it the same emotions, same expectations, or is it different with both guys?
With me, I don't think watching Malcolm race, I don't get as nervous as I did with Little James, because I know when you open that wildcat out of the box, you don't know which way it's going.
Yeah.
And with Malcolm ride in a box. He's always in that box, and you know, so you're pretty much gonna get the same thing out of him.
Yeah.
You know, with Little James, you just never know. If he woke up and, you know, want to show the world something,
yeah,
that's what you're getting.
Do you pre-race chat with them differently? Did you try to motivate them the same way, or is it different techniques?
With Little James, I didn't really have to push to motivate him. He was already, when he got here, he was ready to go. It's just little things that I have to remind him, you know, it's like, if something is not right, you know, I want you to understand it's not right. It's just not your day.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta learn to take what you can, with the hand that's dealt with you on any given day. With Malcolm, it doesn't matter if I'm mad at him or not. Little James is dead. Malcolm, it doesn't bother him.
Yeah.
It's just like, give him an hour, he'll be okay.
Yeah. Hey, so, you know, the video James did, you know, where he announced his retirement and everything, there were some things he said in there that were kind of surprising to me. Like, you know, like he said he doesn't even like going to the ranch anymore because it just brings back memories and everything, and like doesn't like the smell of the dirt and everything. Like, what was that like for you to hear him say that?
Well, it's not really, I mean, it's not, you know, any criticism, because the ranch is what made Little James who he was. Yeah. I think, you know, the whole thing of that, it was like, it was work.
Yeah.
You know, at my facility, it's all work, mm-hmm. and it's no play.
Yeah.
You have to go somewhere else to play. And that's, you know, that's what he said. He don't want to go to work anymore. He yeah. don't want to do that. He hates the, you know, just the ideal of going there.
Uh-huh.
And it's not, you know, bad memories. I mean, we really never been really hurt there.
Yeah.
You know, at the house. So most of the time, it's always been somewhere else.
Yeah. What is it like for you to see him where he's not, like, doesn't have a desire to ride anymore? I mean, what was it like for you? Because I know you raced when you were younger. I mean, do you still ever get the itch to just jump on a bike and fart around a little bit? Or?
If it ain't a Harley Davidson, I don't ride. I just think, you know, it's kind of, you know, just like when people work 40 years on a job.
Yeah.
They don't wake up after their retirement and go bike there. And, you know, and with racing, you don't have to, you know, work 40 years. You can put 10 years, it's like 40 years on a yeah. regular job. And you don't want to go bike. You still, you know, it's still in his heart. He still watches. I mean, he texts me already twice, want to know what's going on, and, you know, about the bike and stuff like that. So he's still into it. He's
yeah.
not out of it. I mean, yeah. he watches every week, every race. And, you know, he's still involved in it. He just don't want to. I think now he's coming back around to understand his kids are getting a little older. Now he can travel with them,
uh-huh.
you know, to racing. But before, he didn't want nothing to do with traveling with his kid on planes and stuff. So
yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think you guys will see Little James at a lot yeah. more races than you.
Might start showing up.
Yes.
That's cool. What's it like watching him racing kids?
Hey, I love it. I mean, just the other day he told me, it's like, you know, I think I'm gonna have to start beating my kids. And I say, oh really? I say, you may have to fist fight them. Nah, I think it's too late. Say, they're telling me what to do now.
Oh man.
I say, welcome to the parents' world.
Yeah. Hey, when it comes to Malcolm, and you know, I know that they got to levels where you had mechanics and stuff, but how do they set up bikes differently from each other? Do they prefer, like, I know James like really stiff front end.
Yeah, Malcolm, the yeah. problem with him is he can adapt. He doesn't really complain a lot.
Uh-huh.
He can adapt to it. And I think that kind of hurts him, because when people ask him questions, it's like, it's okay. You know, so they assume, well, it's perfect.
Yeah.
But it's not. And with Little James, he was like, no, it's not right, this and this and this.
Yeah.
You know, he would, you know, streamline. But Malcolm doesn't really like hurting people's feelings. And so a lot of time he just takes it, you know, ride it on his shoulder.
Yeah, yeah. Well, is it more enjoyable being at the races now? You
yeah.
said you're less nervous, right?
No, I mean, don't get me wrong. I'm nervous because I want him to do good.
Yeah.
But it's just like the expectation of me, what I expect from Malcolm, versus, because, I mean, he's kind of he's a late bloomer in the class, first of all.
Yeah.
So, I mean, he's still learning. Where Little James was at that point where when you win, you expect to win, and you expect to win, and, you know, and that's all we know.
Yeah.
You know, and so it kind of got into, well, if you didn't win, let's figure out why.
Yeah.
You know, so that takes fun out of it. But also, too, you know, when you win, it's, you know, everybody loves you.
Yeah.
But our sport is so brutal, when you lose, they don't know how to accept it.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
So that's why it's just a love and hate relationship.
Yeah. Right on. So in, you know, 5-6 years, you're gonna be coaching some little mini riders?
I'm actually getting ready. I was just telling my wife now that I'm for sure has one rider. And, you know, and if we don't get an outdoor ride, I'm definitely gonna do some summer training. I get people ask me all the time, but my program is not a daddy daycare.
Yeah.
You know, you gotta have work ethic. you know, if you want to come and ride at my facility.
Right on. Well, it's always great catching up. Yeah.